الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أحبت في الله، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، حياكم الله جميعا. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all with ilm nafi'ah, wa rizqan tayyibah, wa amalan mutaqabbilan. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all with fiqh fi deen. And may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bless us with ikhlas, with thabat ala sunnat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. Listen to this beautiful athar of the Salaf, along with the hadith of Nabiyyina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, showing us the importance of how Ahl Sunnah should have ta'awun, how Ahl Sunnah should be gentle with one another, how Ahl Sunnah should be the most understanding and the most merciful to the creation. Listen to this athar of the Salaf. We say we follow the Salafi Minhaj. We say we follow the Salaf As-Salih, but we always throw aside the Minhaj of the Salaf. We always throw away those athar of the Salaf, especially if they show that which we perceive as weakness. But the sunnah is never weak. An Hasan al-Basri, rahimahullah ta'ala, qal, ya ahlu sunnah, tarfaqu rahimakumullah, fa innakum min aqall al-nas. And you'll find this in Shara Usul al-Ittiqad, ahlu sunnati wal-jama'a lil-alalaka'i. Listen to this athar of the Salaf. Imam Hasan al-Basri, rahimahullah ta'ala, said, O Ahl Sunnah, but yet the people get discouraged and belittle Imamina or Shaykhina, Imam Abdul Mahsin al-Abad, when he wrote his wonderful treatise, trying to get the hearts, bring the hearts together. And when Sheikh Ibrahim wrote his beautiful treatise on the Siha, giving advice to the youth to be one Ahl Sunnah. And when Muhammad al-Imam tried to give us some dawabit and some qawaid in his book, Al-Ibana. But the people always have to say something because they don't really want the unity of Ahl Sunnah, and they make a narrow path, a path that we don't know where it came from. We don't know how it's in accordance with the Sunnah of Nabi and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because Ahl Sunnah is gentle. Ruwi al-Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala and Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, ya Aisha, inna Allah rafiq yuhibbu rifq fil amri kulli. Imam Bukhari narrated or collected the hadith of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, in which she said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, Ya Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, verily Allah is rafiq. He is the most gentle. Yuhibbu rifq. He loves gentleness. Fi amri kullihi, in all affairs. Now, what is your excuse for being so harsh and so staunch and so stern against the people, giving the people the bad image of Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah? Ahl Sunnah unite based on Kitabillah wa Sunnati Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and don't fear the blame of the blameworthy. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.